will to prevail and choose for herself. And that's the memo. Now, to be fair, the president struggles with truth all the time. He said last October, quote, "When I can, I tell the truth. I mean, sometimes it turns out to be where something happens that different or there's a change, but I always like to be truthful." So is Ocasio-Cortez just acting like a politician, or does she really think her crazy policies will work? With me now, Center for a Free Economy board member and National Taxpayers Union senior fellow, Maddie Doppler is back. Welcome, Maddie.
Hey, Kennedy.
So there are many problematic areas in her belief system, but the biggest problem is that she actually wants to apply those beliefs practically and change people's lives and the way they are taxed. What do you see as most problematic here?
Yeah, Kennedy, as you pointed out, there's a couple stumbling blocks here. One, of course, being math. The fact that all of the things she has proposed, now, we don't know the full price tag, but we do have some estimates. Medicare for All, supposed to cost $30 trillion. She suggested taxing high-income earners, people specifically making over $10 million, at a 70% marginal tax rate. Well, someone crunched the numbers on those. A couple of different economists looked at that and said, listen, probably at the best, at the high end of the spectrum, we might get $70 billion a year out of that. That is not enough to run the government for more than a couple of minutes most days. So that in and of itself is not anywhere near what you need to make these progressive dreams come true. Now, I do give the Congresswoman some credit. She is able to trot out these old progressive tropes and still get people to take her seriously. That in and of itself is somewhat impressive. But you look at the sheer numbers and the math of what she is proposing, and it simply doesn't work out. Now, I don't think that this is new, of course. Democrats have long abandoned trying to use facts to win the persuasion argument and instead have pivoted to this morality argument. She's just really putting it on the nose where she says, listen, I have the higher moral ground here, so it doesn't really matter whether or not I can justify the policies that I'm proposing because I'm right. I am the oracle of truth. I don't need facts to be on my side because I have divine intervention along the way.
And there is that sincere belief, but you can be as sincere and as purely intentioned as, you know, any angel in heaven. But the problem is the unintended consequences, which we talk about over and over again. We talk about them every night. And she even illustrates the main flaw in her argument, which is you throw a bunch of money at social programs, education, and healthcare, and you have diminished outcomes compared to other countries. Mm-hmm. So why on earth do you want to throw more money at something when the more money you throw it at, the worse it gets? It doesn't make any sense. And she cannot explain away that logical weakness in her argument.
Right. And that's why I say that it's really quite impressive that she is able to recycle a lot of what the progressive left has been saying for decades and make it seem like it actually has a plausibility and possibility of becoming true. You bring up other countries as a good example. She talks about other countries all the time as if they have higher tax burdens and better services as a result, and we should just be able to mimic that here. What she doesn't talk about is the way those tax burdens actually are executed. In these other countries, particularly in Europe, you see a lot of value-added taxes. Those are national sales taxes, which, of course, that means everyone pays those, including lower and middle income families. And when lower middle income families have to pay more for the burden of government, that's a regressive tax. So again, this ability to trot out the rich, sometimes Democrats call them corporations or executives when they want to make them sound particularly villainous. Mm-hmm. It's really effective as a talking point. But when you look at the math and the means of actually paying for some of these programs, they don't actually allow for that to work out. And that's exactly what Congresswoman Ocasio-Cortez is trying to do.
Absolutely right. They don't talk about the cost sharing, and they don't talk about the saving in not having a functioning military. Wouldn't that be great? Maddie Doppler, thank you so much. Good to see you, Kennedy. All right. Yesterday, former President Obama said there is, quote, a deficit of leadership in his party and need for new blood. So much for the idea of